This is the first video in my seatbelt reminder electronics project. Basically, what I'm going to go over in this video is the hardware I selected. The idea for the project is a device that you can power from an accessory outlet in your car, such that when you turn the car on, it powers up the device and it says something to remind you to put your seatbelt on. Reason I'm doing that is because my wife always forgets to put her seatbelt on, and we get rolling, we get the alarm, and I have to say, put your seatbelt on. And I thought, hey, instead of me saying it every time I turn the car on, why not have a device do it? So I want the parts to be minimal. So I don't want to have anything complex in here. That means, you know, in order to do this with a micro, you could have any Arduino, like any Arduino compatible micro, and an I2S DAC and an amplifier. All right, so you could put those together and get spoken audio out, you know, with software. You know, in some cases people use one of those little MP3, you know, you plug an SD card in and you can trigger it to play an MP3 on the SD card. That's all that is more complicated than I want. So for minimal hardware, I decided to use one of my ESP32s because, you know, I guess it's overkill in the sense that it has Bluetooth and Wi-Fi on it, but it has a built-in DAC. It actually has two built-in DACs. So, you know, I have it on hand and I can save an external part. So ESP32. Now, you cannot take the DAC output from an ESP32 and driver speaker. You can't. I tried it. It would be very, very faint. It's just a bad idea. You need to amplify it. However, you gotta be careful, you know, what kind of amplifier you use, because the ESP32 is going to, you know, with the software library that I have, has no volume control. It's gonna range from 0 to 3.3 volts. And, you know, a lot of amplifiers aren't expecting such high voltage on the input. So I just looked around on Amazon and came up with the cheapest little mono amplifier I could see. I got 10 LM386 power amps for about 10 bucks. And there's all kinds of, you know, there's comments in there saying that they're not very good, but, you know, I don't need it to be beautiful audio. So in principle, you can take the output of an ESP32 DAC output, GPIO 25, and just put that directly into the in on one of those modules. Now here's a picture of one of those modules. However, that module is tricky, and I blew out two basically for something that I should have already known. It's tricky in that it has a fixed gain of 200. So it has a gain of 200. So there's a so-called gain control on it that you could use to reduce the gain. But hey, let's look at a sidetrack. Let's look at it under the microscope. Okay, so you can see, you know, the pins, the input pins, you know, voltage, input audio, and two grounds. And then there's that potentiometer. There's a potentiometer on there. Okay, well, how is this all going to work? How does this really work? Well, if we flip it over and take a look at the back, number one, those two grounds are just tied together. So, you know, they give you two ground posts for convenience. You could use one for your system ground. And if you have two wires, you know, for your audio source, one of those would be the negative or ground. You can connect it to the other post. I don't have two wires. I'm just going to have the one wire coming out of the GPIO. So there's an extra ground pin as far as I'm concerned. But if we look at the trace for the input pin, it goes to one side of the potentiometer. And the other side of the potentiometer is connected to ground. Okay. So the middle tap of the potentiometer, if we flip it over and follow the trace, it goes to the input of the amplifier. Well, that's not a gain control. That's not an amplifier gain control, though they say it is. That is voltage dividing the input. A gain control would be something else. So, therefore, what I would say is tricky is that that's a 10K potentiometer. And now, if you start feeding audio ranging up to 3.3 volts coming out of the ESP32, you've got to turn that potentiometer down so that then given a gain of 200, you're not clipping. So, you know, on one extreme, you know, there's no signal. And on the other extreme, you're just clipping crazily. There's a very minute sweet spot where if you play audio out, use a sample program or whatever, and play audio out and turn that pot very carefully, you will get a sweet spot where you'll get the maximum volume without clipping, you know, out to your speaker. Speaking of the speaker, it should drive a couple watts, roughly. I bought some small 2-watt speakers. It's not loud enough. So what I did was I had a little transistor radio that I tore apart for other experimentational purposes. And, you know, I had the speaker left over. So I used that speaker. That speaker isn't rated for 2 watts, but it doesn't really matter. It's not going to kill the speaker. And the speaker costs nothing for me. So, but basically, a bigger speaker made it sound just the right amount of loudness that I need for inside my car. What was the other thing? Oh, yeah, I blew out two because, yeah, do not power it up without a speaker attached. There has to be a load on the output. I am fairly well convinced that in my early playing around with two of the modules, I know I didn't have the speaker attached because I was playing around with speakers. And by the time I got it all, I'm going to do the wiring clean and all this and hook up a speaker, screw it on the terminals and all that. Then I was just getting the best I could get was distorted audio. So, you know, once I thought about it, I said, yeah, I know this. I remember this thing about amplifiers. I don't know if it applies to this kind of amplifier, but just in case, you know, I had 10, so I opened a third one and I wired it up completely before I put power on it and found the sweet spot, and the audio is nice and clean. So that's a little thing, a little bit of a warning. Just in case, make sure you have a load attached to the output. Here's a clip of it actually working in my car. And that seems to work. I mean, it's I have the software timed so that when the board receives power, it waits 5 seconds. It plays it once, waits another 5 seconds. It plays it again because, you know, sometimes people are distracted when you first turn on the car. And as an experiment, When we drove to the store tonight, I tried it. My wife put her seatbelt right on. It turns out, though, that since she knows I'm now working on a project that will remind seatbelts for seatbelts, she's been better about putting on her seatbelt without prompting. So this is the kind of thing that, you know, I might not need for forever. It's an electronics project. So if I get good responses to this video, I will do a video of the full thing. You know, I will show, because I learned a lot while I was putting this together, I will show how to wire up the hardware. I will show what software library you need, or, you know, that I used and I think you need, so that you could have an embedded audio clip on the board that saves you not having to have a disc, an SD card. So that the right software library, and then basically I took the sample program and modified it only slightly to make it do what I wanted it to do, and I'll show that. And, you know, right now it's just all, you know, wires and the ESP32, the amplifier, and a speaker. And I threw it in a cup holder in the back seat and plugged it into my back accessory outlet. It worked fine, as you can see on the video. I'm going to design an enclosure for it that will have a little sound box on it, so that maybe I can get, because the cup holder actually, you know, helped make the sound a little louder. So I'm going to make a 3D design that has a little sound box for the speaker, and it's all nice and neat, and it's something that you could just, you know, leave in the car. So like this video, so I know if I should, because that'll be an effort to make that video, but like the video so I know if I should go ahead and do that. Subscribe to, if you haven't subscribed yet. I do this kind of stuff. I do little electronic projects. I do 3D printing projects, all kinds of maker kind of things. Okay. And so that's the direction I think my channel is going, though occasionally I'll have a little funny short video, because I like to do funny short videos. Thank you for listening to the end. This seems like a long video. I hope it held people's attention.